For more, let's bring in Stephen A. Smith now. Stephen, we all knew the Cavaliers were going to need a special performance from LeBron James to get to Game 7. The Celtics knew it too, but still, there's just no answer for him. What jumped out at you most about his performance?
Well, he's just phenomenal. He's a physical specimen, the likes of which we have not seen. I mean, you can bring up names like Wilt Chamberlain and a few others, but when you consider the fact that he's 6'9", he's 260 plus, handling the ball the way that he has, having improved his jump shot over the years, he can beat you inside or out, and he chooses most of the time to do it from the perimeter. Boston claws within 7. What does this guy do? He hits 2 3-pointers plus converts a 3-point play. He finishes them off. He finishes with 46, 11, and 9. He got contribution in Game 6 from his supporting cast. But when you look at LeBron James, the way he's carrying this team, you just can't say enough. The way he is able to summon up whatever is necessary in order to get the job done on most occasions, you do have to marvel at that. But that doesn't mean they're coming out of the East this particular season. There is a Game 7 in Boston on Sunday.
All right, let's talk about that Game 7. They'll have some questions about Kevin Love after he left this game early. As you mentioned, LeBron James may be dealing with something with his leg. Is there something that they can take with them to Boston that could see them through and give them the kind of success that they've had at home?
All they can have is, or all they can lean on is what they got tonight. What they got Friday night, if Jeff Green and Kyle Korver and Larry Nance Jr., if they show up, and George Hill, if they show up, they maintain a level of aggression, and you can get something, anything, even a bag of cookies from J.R. Smith. It definitely helps. But the bottom line is that who's expecting that to happen? If how Cleveland has performed on the road, particularly against this Boston Celtics team in these Eastern Conference Finals, is any indication. A lot of people who thought, along with myself, who thought that Cleveland was going to win this series, that expectation has dissipated dramatically simply because of what we've seen from the rest of the team on the road. And when you couple that with how tired LeBron looked the last time he was there, Mark Jackson and Jeff Van Gundy were even getting on him. He wasn't hustling back on defense. He was taking plays off. He seemed very fatigued and not into it. That's what happened to him in Game 5. We don't anticipate that in Game 7. But Boston's got a bunch of young Rough Riders who feed off of the adrenaline of that rabid crowd that they have at TD Bank Garden. They will be ready energy-wise. I know LeBron James' game will be ready, but will he have that energy to carry this team, if necessary, to a Game 7? That remains to be seen.
All right, that's why we will watch and see on Sunday. Steve, as always, we appreciate it, my man.
No doubt.